Hi friends, welcome to my simple and new recipes. In this video, we'll see the recipe to make chutney puri. This makes for a very essential accompaniment, whether it is dosa or chapati or roti or even along with the rice and ghee. It is like a must have in every South Indian household. Now let us quickly get started. Before that, if you're new to my channel, do press the subscribe button and press the notification bell for more such videos. Now let us quickly get started. For this I have taken 3/4 cup of kadale bele or chana dal, half a cup of urad dal or uddina bele, half a cup of grated dry coconut and half a cup of groundnuts or peanuts. Now let us look at the other ingredients. I have taken 4 badigi chilies, lemon sized tamarind, some curry leaves, 1 teaspoon of Kashmiri red chili powder. This gives a nice color to the chutney pudi. Hing or asafoetida. Salt you can add as per the taste. I have taken some jaggery. Adding jaggery will balance out all the flavors. Now we will dry roast all the ingredients. Now first I am dry roasting the kadale bele or chana dal. You have to dry roast it till it becomes golden brown in color. Roast it on medium to low flame. Now you can see that it is roasted well. We'll transfer it to a plate. Now we are dry roasting the urad dal. You have to dry roast it on low to medium flame till it becomes golden brown in color. To this I am adding 4 badigi chilies I had taken. You can increase or decrease the quantity of the chilies based on the spiciness you like. I have added this along with the urad dal because it reduces the spiciness of the chilies when you roast it along with the other dals. Badigi chili as such will give a nice color and it is not that spicy. Is roasted well and also the red chilies are also roasted well. We'll transfer it to the plate. Now let us dry roast the peanuts. Roast it on medium to low flame till we see the brown spots on the peanuts. See that the brown spots are there, so the peanut is cooked. Now we will transfer it to the plate. Make sure that you roast all of these ingredients on low to medium flame, otherwise it might burn. Now I am roasting the grated dry coconut. Grated dry coconut will cook in just a minute, so make sure that you have kept the flame on low to medium and keep frying it. Within a minute it will be roasted well. You can see that the grated dry coconut is roasted well. We'll transfer it to the plate. Now we are roasting the curry leaves. I have taken 2 to 3 sprigs of curry leaves. Don't add too much of curry leaves, it will give a little bitter taste. We will keep roasting it till we see that the curry leaves have become crisp and there is no moisture content. Now you can see that the curry leaves have become crisp. Now we will transfer it to the plate. Now I have dry roasted all the ingredients. Now apart from this, we are adding the lemon sized tamarind which we had taken. Now we are adding the jaggery. Adding the jaggery will balance out all the flavors. We will add the salt as per taste. Now we are adding the Kashmiri red chili powders. If you don't have it, you can just increase the quantity of the badigi chilies. This I have added so that it gives a nice color to the chutney pudi. Now we will quickly transfer it to the mixer jar. We'll grind it in 2 batches since the quantity is more, so that it is evenly grinded. Make sure you grind them in short pulses, don't grind them for long because due to the oil content in groundnuts and the dry coconuts, the mixture will become oily, it will not be dry. Grind it into a coarse powder, don't grind it into a fine powder, rather grind it into a coarse powder. This gives a nice taste to the chutney pudi. Now we can see that I have grinded it into a coarse powder and the chutney pudi is ready. Now let us make the tadka. For this I have taken 1 teaspoon of mustard seed, some curry leaves, 2 badigi chilies, some hing or asafoetida. Now to a pan we will add 2 teaspoons of oil. When the oil is hot, we will add the mustard seeds. Once the mustard starts to splutter, we will add the curry leaves. Be careful when you are adding the curry leaves. Because of the moisture content, it will start to splutter. Now we are adding the hing or asafoetida. Now we are adding the badagi chilies. We have added 3 to 4 pinches of hing or asafoetida. Now we will switch off the flame and we will transfer the chutney pudi mixture which we had grinded into a coarse powder to this tadka and we will mix it. You can store it in the airtight container and have it for a month or so. Enjoy this tasty chutney pudi with dosa, chapati, roti or even with rice along with the ghee. If you like this video, do subscribe, like, share and comment for more such videos. Thank you for watching the video.